So, here's where things get really interesting. OpenAI has been showing off these new AI models to the US government, trying to prove they're safe. But safe from what? And who decides? What's really happening behind those closed doors? Stick with me as we dig into what these projects mean, why they're more important than ever, and how they could change everything we know about AI. By the end of this video, you'll understand why ChatGPT-5 might just be the turning point for the entire future of technology. Let's rewind a few months to see how things got to this point. Have you heard about the chaos at OpenAI? If not, buckle up, because the last few months have been a roller coaster. Picture this. OpenAI's CEO Sam Altman was fired out of the blue in November 2023. Imagine the shockwaves that sent through the tech world. It's like someone pulled the emergency brake on a speeding train. But wait, it gets crazier. Just days later, they brought him back. Was this some kind of corporate power play gone wrong? Did someone accidentally send out the wrong memo? Or was it all part of a bigger, secretive plan? It feels like a plot twist from Silicon Valley, but this is real life. And it's happening right now. But that's just the beginning. Things took an even wilder turn when key players at OpenAI started to leave. Suddenly, there were whispers. People were talking about serious safety concerns with the latest AI developments. What was once just a boardroom drama turned into a full-blown debate about the future of AI itself. And then, Q-Star. You've probably heard the name floating around like some AI buzzword, but what exactly is it? And what's going on with Project Orion? And of course, ChatGPT-5, the next evolution of the AI we've all gotten used to chatting with every day. It's like we're living in a sci-fi thriller with new twists unfolding before our eyes, and I'm here to break it all down for you. If you've been following my previous videos, you'll know that Q-Star has been stirring up excitement in the AI community. But what is Q-Star exactly? Let me break it down for you. In simple terms, it's an AI breakthrough that merges two powerful concepts, Q-learning and A-star search. What does that mean? Well, Q-learning is a kind of reinforcement learning algorithm. Picture this. It's like teaching an AI to play a video game. Every time it makes a move, whether it's right or wrong, it learns. Over time, it gets smarter, just like how we humans learn through trial and error. A-star search, on the other hand, is like the ultimate GPS for solving problems. It calculates the most efficient route to get from point A to point B. So when you combine the decision-making power of Q-learning with the precision of A-star search, you get Q-star. This model can tackle problems it's never seen before. It's a huge leap toward artificial general intelligence, AGI, the ultimate goal in AI development. If you've seen my earlier videos, you know that AGI is the holy grail of AI. It's the dream machines that think, learn, and reason like humans. But hold on, let's dig deeper. But before we get into Q-Star's significance, let's talk about one of the key tools driving these AI developments, synthetic data. I know what you're probably thinking. What's this synthetic data thing and why should I care? Great question. Synthetic data is like a perfect clone of real-world data but without all the mess and noise. Think about it. The internet is full of biased, incomplete, and sometimes outright wrong information. If AI keeps learning from bad data, we're going to keep getting bad results. That's where synthetic data comes in. It's clean, controlled, and best of all, it doesn't come with all the privacy and ethical concerns tied to real-world data. Imagine training models like ChatGPT on flawless, custom-made data. The result? Smarter, more reliable, more accurate AI. But here's the kicker. Synthetic data doesn't just fill in the gaps, it pushes AI to a whole new level. Take AI hallucinations, for example. Those moments when AI confidently spits out something totally wrong. Like when it tells you dolphins are fish or suggests you charge your phone by putting it in the microwave. No thanks. Synthetic data helps fix that by providing a perfect learning environment, making sure AI systems are finally learning from the right stuff. Now let's talk about something really exciting. Project Strawberry, remember Q-Star? Well, it's evolved into something even bigger, Strawberry. And no, this isn't just about making chatbots a little bit smarter. Strawberry is on a whole different playing field. It's focused on autonomous research, solving complex problems, and even generating synthetic data to train future models like Orion. It's like that one kid in class who's doing everyone's homework. But instead of helping with algebra, Strawberry is reshaping the future of AI, making everything smarter, faster, and more accurate. And speaking of Orion, this is where things get really futuristic. Project Orion is OpenAI's next big leap, set to surpass GPT-4 in every conceivable way. But here's the mind-blowing part. Orion isn't just a smarter chatbot, it's capable of processing multimodal inputs, meaning it won't just handle text, it could understand images, maybe even videos. And its secret sauce? Synthetic data, thanks to Strawberry. The two together are a powerhouse duo. Think of it like a buddy cop movie. Strawberry's the genius strategist, and Orion's the action hero who gets things done. Together, they're going to change how AI solves problems, reasons, and interacts with the world. And then there's ChatGPT-5. This is where everything comes full circle. ChatGPT-5 is the next step, building on the work done by Strawberry and Orion. This isn't just about making a chatbot that's a little better at conversation. We're talking about an AI that can tackle your hardest math problems, give you flawless tax advice, or even help you with complicated coding projects. And it all comes down to synthetic data, ensuring that ChatGPT-5 will be sharper, more insightful, and, dare I say, more human than ever before. But here's the bigger picture. Why does all of this matter? Why am I saying these developments could literally change the future of technology? If you've been keeping up with my videos, you'll know I've been breaking down the core ingredients of AGI. One of the most critical components we've discussed is reasoning, AI systems that can think like humans, not just follow patterns. And that's exactly what's happening with models like Strawberry and Orion. We're inching closer to AGI, AI that doesn't just mimic human thought, but actually thinks, solves problems, and learns just like us. Now imagine a future where AI isn't just a tool, it's a collaborator. That's what Strawberry and Orion are setting the foundation for. A future where AI doesn't just help us understand the world, it helps improve it. This isn't science fiction anymore. This is real, and it's happening a lot faster than we ever expected. But here's where it gets both exciting and a little terrifying. As AI systems get smarter, we're moving closer to a world where machines could start making decisions on their own. They could define their own goals, set their own objectives. Are we ready for that? That's a question we all need to start asking ourselves, because once we cross the threshold into AGI territory, everything changes. This isn't the plot of a robot uprising, at least not yet, but we need to be prepared for whatever's coming next. So what do you think? Are we moving too fast? Should we be pumping the brakes, or are we exactly where we need to be? Let me know in the comments below. Let's keep this conversation going.